let's now understand the medical licensing process in America. Before I reach to the licensing process, I would ask very simple question to each one of you. Guys, quickly, if you can let me know, what specialization are you guys looking in terms of doing a PG? Okay, this is very important. Because depending on your interest level of doing a PG, things will change. Medicine, all right? Surgery, interesting. Dermapedia, all right. Mm-hmm. Radiology, great. Neurology, all right, great. So, yeah, good. Quickly type in, because this slide will actually determine your entire plan. Okay, doing a PG in America, it's a four-step process where you get a license to work in America, right? Now, what are the steps we will quickly understand? So typically, it's a four-step process. Step one is where you do the entire hard work, right? In the stage one, you are applying for something called as ECFMG certification. What is ECFMG? ECFMG stands for Education Commission for Foreign Medical Graduates. This is the body which certifies that your degree here in India is equal to the American degree, and you are eligible to apply for. How do you get yourself ECFMG certified? By submitting the scores of your MBBS degrees, passing marks of step one, step two CK and CS, which is a practical examination. So if you understand, in all, parallel to your med school, you are going to appear all of these examinations. Okay. So the time spent in the stage one is 5 to 6 years of your career. All right. Along with this, if you want an admission in America, I told you it's the overall profile. So one more requirement is there, is that you are doing clinical rotation. All right. So the clinical rotation is, in simple language, you are working in American hospital for 2 to 3 months in the field in which you want to do PG. So as you guys mentioned, pedia, surgery, neurology. So whoever is interested in pedia will work for 2 to 3 months in an American hospital during internship year. All right. Why is this important? Because it's a requirement as an experience to work in America. B, I will get letter of recommendation from American doctors. These are very important for my admission, right? So at a stage one is when I work hard in terms of building my profile. And in the overall process, I am spending around 20 lakh Indian rupees. That is an investment which I make for achieving my degree and passing the step examinations. All right. This is not an amount which you spend at one go. It is over a period of 5 to 6 years, which includes your exam fees of step one, CK, CS, traveling to America for a CS practical exam and rotations, and your application. All right. Great. So that's the stage one. The stage two is when you do the actual PG. Okay. During stage two, you do your PG for a period of 3 to 5 years. So medicine is a 3-year program. Surgery is a 5-year program. Neuro is a 4-year program. So the number or the length of program depends on the specialization. So if you are interested to, let's say, become a internal medicine specialist, you do 3 years of internal medicine. All right. During the 3 years, per year, you are earning about 35 to 40 lakh rupees. So end of 3 years, you are making about 1 crore Indian rupees. All right. If you are doing surgery, you work for 5 years, you get paid 1.5 crore. There is no tuition fee. You get paid salary. All right. Now, after the way it happens in India, after clearing my you know my medical school PG, I have to give the final exam. So this final exam is called as board examination, right? So I need to clear this board examination, then I am getting the certificate that I am a PG specialist. Once that happens, I have three career choices with me. Career choice number one, that I do come back to India and work as an MD medicine physician in either Indian government job market or private job market. My degree is directly recognized. I don't have to give any other examination. Only difference is I have saved this much money, wherein my friend might have spent this much money to get admission in private medical college. Second option, I will give the step three and work in the American job market. Okay, because once I clear the final exam and step three, I get the state license. Third career option is that I study further. Okay, I decide to study further. So further after medicine, I can become a gastroenterologist, cardiologist, oncologist, nephrologist. These are fellowship programs. Somebody wants to become a cardiologist, does a 3 year of cardiovascular disease fellowship. During fellowship, your minimum salary is 55 lakhs. So in 3 years, you are earning about 1.5 crore. So if you understand the American licensing process, you will realize that your investment was first 6 years of your life, extreme hard work, clearing these exams and investment of 20 lakhs. But the next 6 years of life, you are earning 10 times. I hope this is clear, because what happens is, unfortunately, as a medico, not all of us are economically sound. Economics is equally important, because what happens, somebody does, let's say, MBBS from India, PG from India, and even super PG from India. The average age at which that doctor settles is 32 years. Now, the same doctor who does MBBS from India, but PG from abroad, that is US, the age at which he settles is 27 years. So if you are considering the medical process in America, you are saving 5 years of your life. Now, that's a very big thing when we are seeing the economics point of view, all right? This is highly important for all of us to understand. All right. Hari Teja, it is 1 crore for 3 years. Per annum is 35 lakh rupees. Okay, when I say 1 crore, it is for 3 years. Each year you get paid 45 to 50,000 US dollars. All right. Great. So any questions on this slide? It is very important that all of you should have a complete clarity before we move ahead. Okay, Vipin Joshi is asking, can you discuss strategy for those who are in the final year? Doesn't matter whether you are in final year. This is the overall process. Then we will discuss the timelines. All right, please understand this systematically. Dr. Abdul Qadir, even if you have done MBBS or you are in final year, the overall process is like that. Okay, only difference is if you are in final year or in if you are a graduate, you might have to spend one extra year for step one and 1 year for CKCS and rotation. So beyond this 6 years, you will spend 2 more years. That's all. We advise students to start early so that they can save 2 years. But if you are late, like majority of Indian students, you can spend 2 more years. All right. Umesh Gupta, yes, there are free electives available. But for that, the condition is you have to clear your step one in the 3rd year. Definitely, you can get free electives as well. Great. So now with this clarity, let's move ahead. During this session today, I am going to make a lot of announcements. All right. I would wish each one of you to have a complete clarity and ask me questions as many as you can. So let me make another announcement today. Not every medical college student in India can write the USMLE examination. Okay? In India, there are 500 medical colleges, but only students from these 337 colleges can write the USMLE. If you are from this 114 or these 47 colleges, you cannot write the USMLE exams or get this opportunity for free PG. This is very, very important. So before you dream about American PG, have a reality check whether your medical college approved or not. Because this opportunity is not with every medical college student. How do I check? I go to this World Directory of Med School. Okay. I type on India. And now I can type the med school name. So any of you, just guys, type your med school name so I can check and let you know. Okay. Just give a random your college name so I can just check for your college. Vipin, we will tell you. Don't worry. Your question, I will answer it at the right time. Dr. Abul Qadir, we'll proceed ahead. Not an issue. All right. I have one name from Shruti. Shruti says SMS Medical College. Let us see. I'm sorry. Just Jaipur. Search. In Jaipur, you have Jaipur National University, NIH, RUH, Savai Mansingh, SMS. So as you can see, you can click on this. The college is listed and students from this college can write USMLE, no problem. Okay. However, as you can see, there were other colleges also in Jaipur. I'm not sure all the colleges are approved. Okay, so this is how you check. So let's say we can check for this one. Okay, Jaipur National University. So students from this college cannot write USMLE. Students from SMS can get this free PG opportunity, but students from this college cannot write the USMLE. So I hope you are able to understand this opportunity for free PG is only with these 337 medical colleges in India. So if you are in these colleges, you have a lifetime opportunity to do a completely free PG. All right? Yep.